I'm Thomas Carriero. I'm a software engineer at Dropbox.
I'm Alex Alain. I'm an engineer here at Dropbox.
Yeah, so I was actually the first head TF for CS50 when David Malin took over the class. I had already been teaching CS50 for two semesters with Mike Smith, who was the prior professor there.
So I didn't take CS50, but I did TF it twice, once as a regular TF, and then my senior year I was actually head TF of CS50, which was a lot of fun.
So when David reached out to me about kind of setting up Dropbox in the CS50 appliance, I was really excited because we actually have a Linux client. So most of our users use either Windows or the Macintosh clients, but the Linux, Macintosh, and Windows clients are all actually very similar. So what we did is we pre-installed the Dropbox Linux client in the CS50 appliance, and it runs just like all of our other Linux users.
So the way Dropbox works is it runs as a client on many different operating systems and devices. The Dropbox desktop client is one of the most well-known and one of the most interesting.
So Dropbox basically takes all of the files that you put in the folder, and it chunks those files into 4 megabyte chunks. So we'll take, 100 megabyte PDF file, and we'll chunk it into 25 4 megabyte chunks. Those chunks are then encrypted, and then we send them to our block servers.
The block servers are the storage for the blocks themselves. And so each block is stored in the block server with the data and a SHA-256 hash of that block. That's a very basic encryption primitive that summarizes, in some sense, the data in a very unique way that's unique to that data. You could upload the whole file all at once, but it turns out if you do that, really large files, they take a really long time to upload. And if you have a failure, you're out of luck, you have to restart it. What we then do is we tell another server in our system, what we call the meta server, the metadata server, hey, this is a file and it's composed of the following list of blocks. And we pass up the hashes to identify those blocks rather than re-uploading the whole block. The meta server then checks with the block server, makes sure the blocks are there. If they are, perfect, everything is good.
When we want to basically, download the file from the internet, let's say, we'll ask meta server first, hey, can you tell me about where this file is located? And meta server will say, oh, well, this file is actually 25 4 megabyte chunks, and here they are. And then we'll go to block server and we'll actually download each of those chunks. And then we'll reconstruct the file from there, and then we'll start the download. Yeah, so Dropbox deals with scale basically by very, very aggressive sharding.
So sharding is when you take all of the users in your startup or your company, and they used to be on one database. And that works great until you hit a certain number of users. And really what you want to do is find some way to split those across two databases, or maybe more than two, ideally enough that you can have every user in the world. And so when you shard, what you do is you find some way of deciding which database to go to that doesn't require hitting a central directory, or maybe it's a very quick, cheap lookup in that central directory.
We never have everything stored in one database because that's almost never going to scale. So instead, what we do is we'll take all of that information, all of the files or all of the metadata, and we'll shard it across hundreds or thousands of logical databases. And that means that when we have a request for a user's information, we'll first say, hey, which database is this user's information stored in? And then we'll basically use that decision to go find that database, and that's where we'll load kind of all of the files or all of the metadata about the files. So we use a lot of sharding, but sharding's not always enough. You actually need to cache a lot of the common requests because even those database queries can be expensive. So we also do kind of aggressive caching strategies to make sure that the most common requests are quite easy to compute, and basically that makes it a lot faster and it makes it work at scale. So that's at a very high level kind of how Dropbox works.
My name is Alex Alain.
I'm Thomas Carriero.
And this is CS50.